serious issues such as breast and cervical cancer mortality prevention and focusing dollars on those efforts. I do have a question, however, in the language of the bill and how it actually applies to make this function to ensure that these dollars as allocated are being used for those purposes. Lines 44 through 55, talking about in their operation, such program cannot be used to do any of the following, and then it lists the different types of abortions, which I think, you know, in common discussion in media today, general public, this is not something that is surprising that we would discuss. But I do have a question about the functionality of the bill in lines 54 and 55. It says, if an entity were to become or continue to be an affiliate of any entity that performs or promotes elective abortion, so my question would be, what is the mechanism to stop that funding if this occurs? And also, if a local affiliate is not a provider of abortion, but they are organized through a larger affiliate who is, are they still receiving tax dollars, which in essence would subsidize the greater cost of abortion?
Mr. Chair, to the representative, thank you for that question. So we define affiliate right at the beginning of the bill in line 11. So an affiliate means an entity that has, with another entity, a legal relationship created or governed by at least one written instrument that demonstrates it in any of the following: common ownership, management, or control, a franchise agreement, the granting or extension of a license or other agreement that authorities and that authorizes an entity to use the other entity's brand name, trademark, service mark, or other registered identification mark. So what this was trying to do by expanding it beyond the facility, but anybody that they contract with or anybody that they have an affiliation with. So it was meant to capture those possible loopholes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Is there any mechanism in place? Obviously, this will have to go through finance at some point because it's dealing with allocations, but is there any mechanism in place if somebody is not an affiliate of an abortion-providing agency of any sort, and then they become one? What happens from that point to the next point if that is the scenario or the chain of events? Does the funding cease immediately? Is there a clawback? Do we have any idea how that functions as of yet?
Good question.
A lot of this is covered in a bill by Henry Hyde some time ago in Congress, where tax dollars, and that's what we're really talking about, that tax dollars are not used for elective abortions, thereby medicating people who are prevented from doing this. This bill intends to have a state auditor, whoever is necessary, to come in when there is or when there is knowledge of what it's called usually in financial circles, commingling, or the use of funds to promote things that are not contracted for in your contract with a state-funded entity, or state dollars, or federal money.
Representative Clay. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I have two questions. The first one is, it's not a question, it's more of a statement.